Hello guys and welcome. In today's tutorial video, I'm going to demonstrate to you how to process a credit note. A credit note is processed in order to reverse a tax invoice or to refund the customer of all or some of the payment that the customer has given to the entity for exchange of the goods or services provided by the business. So we can prepare a credit note for the reasons of the customer retaining the goods due to them either being damaged, either being faulty, or in a case where the customer changes their mind and they return the goods to the business. Now, in the previous video, I have mentioned that I have received some inquiries from you guys requesting me to demonstrate how to perform a certain function on pastel accounting, and I have drafted those inquiries as shown. The first inquiry was to demonstrate how to reverse or delete a document. The second one was how to attach an invoice to an email that is going to a client. The third one was how to process a credit note. Now, the first two inquiries have been dealt with, and those tutorial videos are contained there in the channel. Now, the third inquiry, that is what we're going to be dealing with right now. Now, as we have said, that the credit note is used to reverse a document. Now, it means the third inquiry now links to the first one, that is reversing or deleting a document. So we have said that a tax invoice or invoices rather, either a tax invoice or a sales or a supplier invoice can only be reversed using a credit note / a debit note. And then deleting a document, we have said that you can delete the documents such as sales order, the purchase orders, the goods received notes, and so forth. So now we're going to be dealing with a credit note that is used to reverse the tax invoice, as you cannot delete the tax invoice, but rather you can reverse it. Now let's go back to Pastel and demonstrate that. Now I'm going to be using the customer that has not transacted with the business as yet, so that you can get a clear understanding of whatever that you're going to be doing. Now you can see that the balance of this customer is zero, the balance of last year is zero, the sales last year is zero as well. So it means that the customer has not transacted with this particular business in the previous year or in the current year. So this is Daniel's Bob. Now what I'm going to do now is that I will first go and process a tax invoice for this customer. So there, the document type is the tax invoice. I'll go to customer and select Daniel's Bob. There's the customer selected. Now I can just choose to tick this invoice, to tick this inclusive. And this means that if you tick inclusive, you will see that the price changed to inclusive price. If you tick it, it changes to exclusive price. So now it means that the price that you're going to insert here has to correspond with this. Then I'm going to move on. Now, I need to select the product that I'm invoicing this particular customer for. I'll just say it's massage balls, sorry. And then the quantity, I'll just say it's only one. And now the price, remember that you cannot, if you are processing a customer, the price will be given to you. But remember, in this case, we have not set any prices for our products. So now it means I can just resort to inserting the price manually. Now, the cost price for this was 43.86. Thus, the price that I'm going to sell this to, I'll just assume it was 60 rands. And then there is our tax invoice. Now I need to update. So let's just change the quantity to 2 so that it can be a little realistic. And then let's go to batch and update this particular tax invoice. So now it says, do you need to print this particular invoice? No, not now. No, I don't want to print. Then I'll click on update. Now the invoice is updated. Now if I go to this particular customer, I'll click on edit customer, I go to the account. I need the account of Daniel's Bob. I'll go to balances. So now you can see that the customer has transacted with us this year, and then the balance is 120. And then on the sales, it says sales for this year was 105. Why is there a difference? The difference is as a result of VAT. That's why it says sales for this year is 105. Because remember that the tax, the VAT, is only collected for third party, so it doesn't belong to us. Then I'll just close this. And now what I'm going to do is that if you look at the customers, which is Daniel's Bob here, now the customer's balance is 120. So this means that we invoiced this particular customer, but we did not receive this cash right away. Now, let's assume that the customer now brings back the goods, and now we have to reverse this particular amount right there. So you'll have to go to process customers again. And then in this case, you'll select a credit note. And then you'll look for the customer, which is Daniel's Bob. It says the date you have entered is out of period. Click on OK. Okay. So now we'll go to the remember that on the tax invoice that we have created, the price was inclusive. So after that, you'll click on link or create. So we'll link this to the tax invoice. And then the tax invoice that we're linking to is this one that we have just created previously. Then quantity to use two, because the customer will assume that he's bringing all those goods back. Then we link. Now remember that for a credit note, you need to update using what, the next document. But for you to be sure of that, you need to check first on what batch. I'm sorry, for credit note, you update using batch, not the next document as such. So you'll go to batch and then you click on update this particular credit note. And then you'll click on cancel if you don't want to print. Then, no, I don't want to print. Then I'll click on update. Thus the credit note is updated. Then I'll click on close. I'll go back to the account of this customer, which is Daniel's Bob. I'll look for Daniel's Bob. Here's the customer. Then I'll check the balances. If you look at the balances, now the balance is reversed by what? By that particular credit note. So that is how you reverse a credit note. That is how you reverse a tax invoice, rather. So this marks the end of today's tutorial video. Remember that if you have any inquiry, you can just add it to the comment section below, and I shall add it to the list of inquiries there. And then the next tutorial video will be based on processing the statement of financial position.